Today we'll take a look at how to do a product bulk import. Let's begin. To do a product bulk import, head to the menu on the left and click on Product. This is the product page, and at the top right hand corner, click on the button Bulk Import Product. In the pop-up menu, click on the words Product Import Template to download the Excel file. This is what we'll be using to import the products. For today's example, we will import 3 different beer products. The Excel file contains 17 fields, but not all of them is required. I'll go through each of them slowly and explain how to fill them up. Feel free to pause at any time to read the description on each of the fields. The first field is product handle. The purpose of the product handle is mainly for the import-export process. Product handle typically follows the SKU of the product, which we will get into later. Each product handle must be different, so that the system can understand that you are uploading a different product each time. The only time a product handle will be identical is when there are variants of a product. This is a compulsory field, which means that you need to fill it in. Next is SKU. SKU is a unique number or code that is usually assigned to an individual product. You can think of the SKU as the code number or code name for the product. This is a compulsory field as well, so remember to fill it up. Category name refers to the category you wish to sort the variant into. If the entry you filled in is a new value, a category will be created based on that value. Product name is the default name that your product will assume. This is a compulsory field, so do remember to fill it in as well. Similar to product name, product description is the default description of a product. However, this field is optional, which means that you can leave it blank if it's not applicable. Product open price is a true or false field, which, to simply put, is a yes or no value. Product open price helps to determine whether your pricing is fixed or flexible. If the variant has a flexible pricing, key in true, and if it's fixed, key in false. Variant name override is the name of the variant. If this is filled in, it will replace the product name. As indicated by the label, variant name override is usually only used when there are multiple variants. And if this is not applicable to you, you may leave it blank. Since we will not be using this in today's example, we shall skip it. Similar to variant name override, variant description override will replace the current product description. If it's not applicable, leave it blank. Variant base price is the selling price of your product. This is another compulsory field which you have to fill in. Barcode raw is your barcode number. For products with multiple barcode number, you can link them using commas. Variant supplier is simply the name of your supplier. Supplier code is a unique code that identifies the supplier of the goods. Variant cost price is how much it costs to purchase the product. This is different from variant base price, which is the selling price of the product. Attribute name refers to the additional characteristic of a product. Attribute value refers to the value of the attribute that sets it apart from the other variants. Text type can be keyed in and applied to the product. However, there must be an existing text type created on the back end. If this is not applicable to you, you may leave it blank. Lastly is composite. Composite is a mixture of products that are sold in a bundle. This is a true or false field. So if your product is a composite product, indicate true in the cell. And if it's not, indicate false. Now let's fill in the file with the rest of the products. Remember the compulsory fields, which are your product handle, SKU, product name, and variant based price. Once you're done, save the file and head back to the backend system to upload it. And that's it. If you were to look at the product menu and search for your product, you would see that it has already been added into the inventory. You can also choose to add image by clicking on the image tab at the top of the menu. Once you're done, save and exit. If we were to check on our POS system, you can see that the product is ready and available for sales.